You're absolutely from day one.
You know.
Hold on a second. No, yeah. you're absolutely right. From day one, not one police officer, not the sheriff, not the police chief, not the undercover officers, not one person, not the business owners, nobody said anything derogatory. In fact, they said contrary to that, that you have been unbelievable in terms of mature, gentlemen, ladies, intelligent, great protest. Yeah, there's never been anyone who complained about that.
It can't go back down, but at least it's up.
How many folks actually occupy here?
Well, I'm told that about 10 people every night on average sleep in this camp. Whether or not there's 10 at any given point in the night, but that's what I'm told. I personally live in Green Bay. I occupy it, so I'm not here about it.
Is there really an occupation if you have no one sleeping here? One or two people sleeping here? Is that really an occupation?
I think that there's a distinction to be made between the idea of an occupation and the occupying land. We have occupied land, but what we aim to do is to occupy the process and change it from something controlled by corporations and money to something controlled by people and the will of people.
Does it show a lack of commitment if a lot of folks never stayed here?
I don't think so.
Isn't it a false impression given to the public that you are occupying here if so few people occupy?
Well, let me put it this way. This encampment has been a public forum. There are always people here. The city council building is a public forum. Bill Peduto doesn't sleep in his office.
Right there!
There's always someone there to maintain the office.
Right there! Stand up! Right there! Stand up!
As you imagine, there's never more than one person here.
Right there! Stand up!
Fight back!
Stand up!
Fight back!
Stand up!
Fight back!
He didn't say that. Stop trying to report bias news.
I was here on nights when there are more rats than people staying here.
There's more rats in here right now!
Yeah, go ahead. Talk yourself out.
I wasn't there to confirm, so I really can't comment on that. But
is it an occupation when you have one person here? Is that an occupation? By definition.
What's the point of an occupation, Hardy?
If there's no one occupying.
It's not to stand around. It's not to sleep in the grass.
Well, then why have the tents if you're not going to sleep here?
Because we're maintaining the space as a public forum. If there was nothing here, it wouldn't be maintained as a public forum. You guys wouldn't be. It would be empty. It would be melon green. But instead, it's People's Park.
What happened to so-called Blue Thunder? What happened to him? Your former spokesman. What happened?
I don't know where he's worried about
something. Did you know he's a sex offender? You're laughing. It's serious stuff.
Well,
multiple sex offender was your spokesman.
He was first spokesman.
Occupy never had a spokesperson.
Claimed he was a spokesman. You had a spokesman named Blue Thunder who had a significant number of arrests for sexual assault. Is that what you want to represent you?
You should track him down.
Speaking of sexual assault, how about that Dallas Cowboys fake rape charge you came up with, Marty?
Is that what you would want to represent?
Look, Marty, obviously no one here had any idea.
What are you,
of
Fox?
His
Fox News?
When it became aware, he left.
Are you pleased with the turnout today?
I am. And I'm glad you came.
And do you folks plan on staying? I'm glad too. Did the folks plan on staying?
You know, as we've been saying all along, everyone here is an individual. They make decisions for themselves. I myself will not be getting arrested this year. Other people will do what they do.
Right. Anybody here, raise your hand if you're going to stay. Stay? You're going to stay in the tents at night. You are? You are?
I have been, and I haven't seen you around.
I haven't seen you either.
I've seen your camera at 4 in the morning.
And you're going to stay?
I'm here to protect the people. I'll be here as long as the people are here.
And you, sir, you're going
to
stay?
Yeah, I mean, I'll stay as long as I can. I'm going to try to avoid getting into trouble. And I will, you know, but I will. I have been staying here. I've been here since October 20th.
Hmm. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, folks, for being very nice.
Thank you for coming. There's actually people here.
I appreciate it. All of you folks, 7, 9, 11, 4:30 in the morning. And I interviewed a couple business owners. Kevin Joyce owns a restaurant here, the Carlton. He's been here through 100 times.
never saw more than one or two people. Police officers say that any given night, never more than three people. The most people that ever been here are left. So, I mean, you're occupying it or not.
If you say any given night, you're talking about since October?
After November.
After November?
After November. Got really.
Do you have a date? Exact date? After November what?
They said it went. Everything kind of went.
So you're no operating. So you're operating like you're saying.
No, on police intelligence, photographs, and video, my own video.
Oh, really?
Yeah, what I witnessed.
So you're willing to share that video?
Whatever we have.
Or whatever you have. So we're so glad that we're here as Occupy Pittsburgh now to record all the
questions. No, I appreciate everything you guys are doing.
So that, that way you don't chop it up.
Thermal imaging, huh?
The thermal imaging.
Dave, you caught me my tip clamp.
The thermal imaging, does the thermal imaging camera shoot through Mylar? Because most of these tents are winterized with Mylar.
I know. Well, according to the...
Did you knock on everybody's tent? Did you
went into the firefighter.
Did you look inside and see how many people? Did you do a census or anything like that?
Well, we were here multiple times.
Well, so you're basically guessing, you're estimating, and you're trying to make a story out of it.
Say what you want.
Well, exactly, because you're
thermal imaging actually sees through, if you knew anything about it, it detects heat through whatever the
product is.
Through
my space blanket.
Through my space blanket.
Really? Is that what it does?
All of us, a lot of us have jobs. A lot of us would
skip the events you should occupy.
Listen,
you have a car? Are you in your car all the time?
I don't park my car in a car.
Do you have a second home?
I sleep in my home. If this is your home, sleep in it.
Do you have a second home?
No.
No, you don't have a second home. So we can check on that and see. Well, why would it matter to you? Occupy the people's part. It's a physical manifestation of the Occupy movement. It is not the Occupy movement.
Well, why put tents here?
Well, because
you're going to sleep here, because
you
never
saw you here. Because you see all these people here? This is a public forum. This is the people's park.
Are you going to stay?
I don't stay here. The misconception of the Occupy movement is that it is made up of just what you see.
I see a bunch of tents that are empty.
You know what an iceberg is, Marty? How much of an iceberg do you see above the water?
Well, you see the polar bears actually staying on the ice.
Good point.
Here we go. I'm done. Thank you.
Yes, you are done.
We can talk all day. Thanks for your help. You guys have been great.
You've been wonderful, Marty.
Cancer-causing chemicals used in this fracking of Marcellus wells. Smarty?
Well, Maya, I know what your problem is. You have been drinking too much Metamucil. Next caller, please. We have a call from Governor Ben Dell from Charlottetown, PA. Go ahead, Governor.
Smarty, my favorite song happens to be Behind Closed Doors by Charlie Rich. Do you love that song, Smarty?
When we get behind closed doors. Great song, Governor. Next call, please.
Okay, Hades Flavor from Burnsville, PA. Go ahead, Hades. This is Smarty.
Hi, Smarty. Hades Flavor here. I just want to say that our industry is perfectly safe. I frequently take my own children to Frack Park to swim. We project thousands of lifeguard jobs for Pennsylvanians in the next 20 to 30 years. What say you, Smarty?
You're exactly right, Hades. Lifeguards will have employment for many years to come. Okay, we have to move on here. Okay, oh, that's lunch already. Pete Z. Rella in Oil City, PA. He says, the topping on a BPX Everything Pizza is a trade secret, but perfectly safe to eat. They've been making them the same way for 100 years. Thank Pizzy's honest guy. The truth will set you free. All right, we're back to the show. We have Paul Polluted Stream on next. Go ahead, Paul from Frack Mill, PA.
Smarty, this is Paul Polluted Stream. Are we on yet?
Oh, yeah, you're definitely on. Come on.
Smarty. This industry has destroyed forests and wildlife. It has polluted our streams, killed the fish. There are violations left and right. They're destroying our wildlife.
Oh, sorry about that. Sorry, I owe you a call back, Paul. Next governor, Governor Horvath from Bribery, PA. Go ahead, Governor.
Smarty, this is Governor Horvath from Bribery, PA. I love this country. See, I'm tired of all the belly aching. My personal revenue went up over 900 stacks thanks to this great fracking gas. And what? These people are good to me. I can't show them my appreciation. Smarty, I assure you, this has nothing to do with my loyalty to deranged, bad habit, or tail licking industries. And oh yeah, did I forget to say, I love stale properties too.
Great presentation. Okay, alright, give me the next call. Okay, last caller from Moscow, PA, Tom Bridge.
Hello, Smarty.
Yes.
This is Tom Bridge here from Moscow, PA. What we need to do here is hunt down every threat to our homeland security. And this should include and not be limited to nursing mothers, elderly protesters, or preschoolers that hold up signs that say, please don't poison my water. What say you, Smarty?
Wait a minute. I disagree. I think it should only be limited to nursing mothers. Well, that ends our segment for today. Up next is the Mike Pinhead Show.